He jumped up.
We were working on a move. We were showing moves out of kata. We had this move out of a kata, and the hand comes like this. And I told people that the root of the seventh facial nerve is right here. The nerve branch into the face like that. Stomach 2, 3, and 4 come down here. This is stomach 5. Stomach 6 is here. It comes up like this on this side, the stomach meridian. Actually, that move in the kata is raking out at somebody's face, but it's taking those nerves and stretching them. So that's why the hand passes this way. If you look at it, it's natural. There's your opponent, there's your hand, and it pulls this way. Some of the katas even do this. If you were in my class, where the legs feed together, some of the katas go like that and lock legs as you do this move. That would injure the individual because you're going to feed the energy from both legs up into the striking hand and you would strike. If somebody grabs you and gets rough on you, and a big guy like this is liable to do this to a little guy like me, you're mean. Okay. He don't want to be mean. Be mean. We lock in here, we pull, and I'm only going to tap on stomach 5 and show you what it would be to put him down. The actual move should be a chop, but I didn't want to injure him, and it should be to the root of the seventh facial nerve.
My God.
Beautiful. While you're down there, it's not a total loss. No, stay there. Person diving at you, there's a move in the kata goes like this. I have a kata, it opens up, and it actually goes like this. One hand goes up, one hand goes down. It even reverses and attacks the person. But you have 3 gallbladder points up on the head. You have a triangle right here, and you have a triangle right in the back of small intestine points on both sides. If someone's driving at you to try to take you down, if he reaches out, this will come up on the forehead, this will come down on the small intestine. It'll look exactly like the kata, and if he reaches out, as I do that, he's gone. Turn him towards the camera.
That's what we live for. So this comes off the punch as he punches to me here.
Everybody quiet.
I want to catch him on this side here and set him up on here. And then move in this way here and then come up to here. Move into the small intestine 18, gallbladder 20 this way. So as he punches here, to me here, right here.
Right here.
There we go.
Good.
That's jujitsu at its best.
Knocked him out about 4 or 5 times, didn't I?
Yeah.
I don't believe it, he said. I just don't believe it. Nobody can do that to me. Well, he can't do it again to me. Okay, who else is up? We like to have fun with it. Who else is up?
Dun, dun, dun.
The healer. The healer. I thought you were a healer.
I changed for a minute.
You have to figure out people. One of the things, remember the, one of my all-time favorites, it's stomach 25. You find stomach 25, it's horizontal with the navel, and it's about 1.5 sun away from the, actually it's 2.
Those are some inches.
About an inch and a half away from the navel.
What's that, in metric?
It's right here. Here it is. When they grab you, in this, they tighten up everything here. No, you're grabbing.
We're not
grabbing. We're,
you're mean.
Guys are killing.
What happens is this particular move, the energy shuts off from the elbows up, but everything down here turns on. Now we don't want to hurt him, so we're just going to let his hands relax. But the stomach 25 is just like this, just like in the move in the kata. Boom. But we do it like this. Boom.
What we're doing is coming off of Pinon 2. Move comes here, comes across, and back.
Quiet back there.
What we'll be doing, my opponents grab me here. For the cross hand grab. What we'll be doing with the first move is taking his wrist up and grabbing the fire and metal points here on the wrist as it goes in the kata. I'm going to come here into the lung point on the arm, bring him down, and the move coming back, grabbing gallbladder for here, and then the punch as it goes in the kata.
Wow, that's good.
Kusanda, we have the moves to come forward here, here, and here. That's telling me is if I go to gallbladder in the head and I tweak down like that, pull him forward.
Yeah, you pay attention to what you're doing. Don't look at that.
Okay, I pull forward like this and I hit here. Now, if that didn't put him out, I would go to small intestine 18 or small 5, but I'm just going to go. Knuckle right here.
Yeah. Whoa. And his legs there. His legs.
Hit him up.
I love when their legs cramp.
When they go straight.
Yeah.
Using just lighter touches with changing a person's energy. If a person locks up and does this and grabs you, really locks up, this becomes locked out where you really can't give much to it. I want to do release his pectoral muscles up here to relax him out. I'm going to touch him inside. Right? Uh-huh. I'm going to touch here. Now I get him to drop down.
Very nice.
Hopefully
that was excellent.
Okay.
Excellent.
Bring him in this way here, just to me. I need to reach up and it's behind triple warmer 17, small intestine 18, and I need to work through him.
Ready? Oh.
A lot of the techniques out of that form can be off of double lapel grabs. The movement is going to, the hands are going to come like this, the foot's going to step forward, and the hands are just going to slap just in that manner. That. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take the positive side of my hand, I'm going to stick it on the negative side of his face. I'm going to take the positive side of the back of this chicken bone, I'm going to stick it on that negative side of his body. Double lapel grab. He's going to grab in close. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tap him on the stomach, set him up, and push the head over. As I do, it stretches out the torso. I'm going for spleen 15, up and in, 45 degree angle. Oh. Move. This is that Kusan Ku. The hand proceeds forward like this. This pointing to the elbow tells me three things. Either I'm going to use the pressure point, it's either going to be pressure point, area control, or organ. So this tells me that I can use the point itself, I can use the elbow, or I can affect the heart. So what's going to happen? Hand comes out like this, hand comes forward. Take the body, I'm going to spin it. Just like this, just in the form. Foot's out. I'm going to take stomach, or come like this, telling me I'm going to affect the heart. By sticking my knuckle in stomach 9, in and down, in and up affects the stomach, in and down affects the heart. Yeah. Sets up conception 14, the hand's going to dump in this manner. Like this, punch and the hands cross. This tells me I was either grabbed at long range or short range. Long range, I would just feed in to grab ear, which it tells me to do. If it's already short range, I don't need to do this because the ear will already be here. If he grabs me, I go to grab the ear, which we're talking about in advanced class. If he pulls his head back, the next punch in the forearm sets him up, bring him closer to me. Okay. Stomach 45, stomach 9, stomach 5, up and in 45 degree angle this way, but turned over in this manner, angle injection is this way. Just like the form. He grabs, I got to reach for the ear, he pulls back, set up the stomach.
Also in the pinion 3.
You can't knock him out, he's too deadly.
The hand comes up and then comes down as well.
We've seen sawdust pretty bad, don't we?
We've seen us don't do this application out of it many times. But one of the things we do when breaking down kata is the multiple interpretation move. So I began to wonder, what if instead of catching him off this side, I caught him out here, or even over the top? If I caught him over the top, I could go into pericardium 2, the pericardium 1 from in here. If I came underneath, and he came up as a maybe a bigger, taller person, I could pop him on triple warmer 12, come back on the pericardium 2, and stomach 5. And if this didn't put him out, that's where we come in behind, because I could grab the ear on the gallbladder point to go on into spinning throw, or if he had hair, I could grab the opposite quadrant and spin around and do the down attack and whiplash his neck. But from in here, I'll bump triple warmer 12, I'm back in pericardium 2 to yin and yang him, and then stomach 5.
Yeah, now it goes. That's the light.
Shouldn't matter whether I'm fighting a guy empty hand or whether he has stick or knife as well. If he's this move out of Nahanchi 2, from in here, comes back and out. If he's thrusting in with a knife, this part here is telling me that I need to pick him up on the outside from in here. If I were to pick him up from in here, he could just turn and cut me. So I have to pick him up here. I can latch on to the heart and large intestine points over here. If he's got a small knife, I can turn it back into him, like in this. But if he's got a large blade, I can touch this up, open him up, and just put him down and out from there.
Good.
I want to set this up inside here this way. Come down along here, catch him on gallbladder here, and then touch him over here. All right? Side here, this way, here, reach in.
A lot of now, we're seeing a lot of people coming in. Working with somebody that did high school wrestling, collegiate wrestling, some of the jujitsus are teaching people to come in and do a takedown like this. This is one we developed for somebody's trying to tackle. So what he's going to do is he's going to come in, I'm going to squeeze the trapezius muscle, okay? And notice my hand goes backward. And then on the scapula, there's a place right in the middle called bladder 38. Okay, on some of the charts, some of them it's 43, depends on whether it's Chinese or Japanese. And I'm just going to do a little cheese strike there. So we'll turn around, let people see where it is on the back, where my finger's pointing. Okay, we're going to go through slow once. Dave, in here. Okay, just come in slow once. Going for the tackle here, and smack. Okay, this time for real.
Shows a move this way, grabbing, and here. If you watch and pay attention to several styles, and I've noticed it's different in each style, some of them raise the foot and come into a cat stance when they come in and do this. That's for coming in and cheating on the foot. What we're going to do is we're going to use the knuckles right along the soft part of the head. All I'm going to do first is I'm going to show you how it's going to react, and then I'm going to tap. Here this way, you're going to use a motion of going side to side, spins the head. If I twist, watch his knees, he'll drop. The motion is one, just go down, I'm going to keep it light. I'm going to grab the hair, hold tight, I'm going to take the knuckle and tap into stomach five. Teeth together. Teeth together.
Pay attention how light you touch. Very good, Dave. Very good.
They knock out.
Dave Peterson. Okay, I'm going to do a knockout on stomach meridian. I'm going to get behind him. You're waking up to be okay. I'm going to hit on stomach five, probably cross over on six. To show you what could happen to you in the street with just a slap if I throw energy with it. I not only throw energy with it, I have the intent, that's so important, intent to do whatever. So I'm gonna just touch. I don't get anything at all, right? Now I won't hit much harder than that, maybe not as hard. Touch a couple warmer and go back.
Actually, I need another volunteer. Mr. Golden, pick one of them. All right, yeah. First, how many people are here again for the first time? All right, before you came to seminar, as long as Master Dillman's been going around and the Dillman theory has been there, there's still people that say, you know, pressure points are too hard, you can't get into them. The problem isn't with the Dillman theory, it's just with the way people practice it. They take a little bit from the book or a little bit from a seminar, go home, try and get the technique, and the technique don't work because they're, you know, overlapping or doing something wrong. You have to decide, all the pressure points work, but you have to look at the body type of the person with what you're gonna do. Now the technique, I need another volunteer if I can. Somebody
like that, me.
Somebody that looks like Doc Dave. One of the technique I'm gonna use is that a kata nahachi. Start to kata off, cross over, and then it comes out. I'm gonna end starting it going this way. The crossing over, as Master Doma said, you could be treading, but I'm gonna use this as a kick. I'm gonna come into spleen six as I cross over. I'm gonna start it from a grab. I'm gonna lock into the wrist points, because as you crossed over, that hand came to your wrist, and then this hand comes out. And when Master Dillman's talked about that kata before, the strike isn't here. I'm not fighting a person over here and leaning over and slapping him. The person is here, I'm taking him here and bringing him to over here. So I'm gonna use that technique with the wrist and the spleen, and I'm gonna go into conception. Exception four, with just this part, I'm not going to use the head. With Clint's body type, he'll respond with Conception four vessel. The spleen six is where the three yens cross in the leg. Conception four is where all three yens on both legs come up and meet. Right into there, locking in.
Get his back straight. Oh, is that good? I'm amazed.
To respond to, it's kind of like finding the proverbial needle in a haystack. If you have a nice washboard stomach, like Master Dillman was saying, it's all ripped and it's right there. If you have a little bit of a pouch, you don't feel that, even connecting to that. So I'm gonna use the same technique, but now instead of taking that with this, I'm gonna leave out the opening part, just grab, kick, and then that opens up, because the yin spleen six, it's a yin point, it'll bend you and also turn you. So that comes right up for gallbladder 20, my yang. All right, same thing for grabbing.
Really nice light touch.
Yeah. I tried to do both.
Give him a round of applause.
Just gonna demonstrate metal and do a wood. It's just a nice simple connection. And the secret though, as I have practiced, is that we want to see an early reaction. Master Dillman was saying that if you don't get a strong initial move, the second move is going to have to be real hard. Well, I like to use soft second moves. So if we're going to use this technique, I expect to see a nice dip. See, like a little rock and roll there. So you get in there and you get a little dip. So if we don't get that native move, the next move is going to have to be real strong. So that's one thing when you're practicing, to develop a sense of what's happening first. Okay? So it's just basically going to be a nice move here and then a closed move there for gallbladder. So we just go ahead and get it stimulated a little bit. There you go. And then.
Oh, good, man. Wow.
And the hachi goes this way. That tells me that I got to go inside on the leg. I do a lot of women's seminars, and what if a guy grabs me? Okay? What if he's got me in a bear hug or something like that? What if he grabs me there? Okay, if he does that, don't get me so tight right now. Okay, I can get spleen here, I can get spleen here. Okay, and that'll make him go that direction. And I'll just tap in like we do. Stomach five. So he grabs me, I'm gonna go here, here. Yeah. Light as I can make it. Very light. Okay, he's grabbing me. Okay, I'm gonna get the lung point here. That's gonna offer me the head. I'm going to take the head and stretch him out, and I'm just gonna tap him just like that. Okay?
Really?
I get lighter with that every time.
Approach to it, as opposed to on the first shot using my hands, my fingers, my elbows, the knees, or the feet. I'm going to use my chin from a headlock. So as he gets me into a headlock, this is way. As he gets me into a headlock, I'm going to catch large intestine in the arm, come back on gallbladder, which is going to loosen him up this way. I'm going to catch in the stomach 17.
created monsters.
just another application or breakdown for this. When you chamber, get ready to turn and down block. If the person grabs, like they're gonna punch, inside the arm here, the lung meridian we would attack, which is yin, and stomach five, which is yang. Well, now I'll water it down, because I don't wanna chip your...
Keep it together.
Oh, well.
Whoa. Well, that's good. He dropped fast.
Kata cento, when it comes back like this, and then the palm. Off of a same side arm grab, I'm going to come up, activate triple warmer three with my thumb, with my middle finger, activate large intestine four, drop back into a cast stance, activate gallbladder 13, 14, and 15. Off from a same side arm grab, come up, get on this, step back.
You got him, you missed on the three gallbladders. You still went.
I like this technique because it's one of the ones that I can do the lightest. It's a technique out of kata seisan. You go here and here. And what I do is I have it in a dynamic situation where the guy is trying to punch me. As he steps forward with a punch, I'm going to sidestep. I could attack his arm. I mean, if he gets his hand in there pretty quick, I could, as he brings your arm in, get a two-bone strike here and a palm pericardium here. I could get a fire and metal combination with this and then follow with the next one, but you don't need that much setup. What I like to do, if I can get enough movement quick enough, is particularly a guy's doing a big John Wayne punch, he's coming in from downtown and giving you one here. I want to step to the side as he comes in, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to palm stomach three. We're going to hit it up in that direction, up and out. So that's this hand, palming in and up. The other hand comes around and connects with gallbladder, so we have a cycle of destruction here. This being an earth point, this being a wood point. I'll strike this way. So as he comes in the step,
he's a brave soul. One of the things that I've done before, I like Chris says, to demonstrate principle, not necessarily a particular technique. One of the things that I've done before is to demonstrate how simple it is if you use three strikes on the same point, how easy it is to knock a person out. I'm going to take the gallbladder point directly above the eyebrow and just tap it three times and hopefully put him out.
Stand, relax.
Nice and relax.
I don't want you to get hurt.
Okay. One, two, three.
Wow. Get him back.
Good, and I tried it once and it didn't work, and that really kind of faked me out. I couldn't figure out what I did wrong, but what it was is we were talking about the stances and stuff, and if you do it, and the person grabs you and you're grabbing on to hitting small intestine and large intestine on the small intestine, three on large intestine. When you step across, what happens if the person rocks his body, puts all the weight on one foot and comes off this way, and you strike this side, it kind of nullifies the attack. And I didn't realize that until I looked at it, but if you make this grab here like this, and the step comes down here, the tap comes crossed.
It's now he's up.
Nice.
Okay. Wow.
Nice one.
I didn't have any volunteers. This guy is going to go all the way back to St. Louis. So
he'll be okay.
I'm going to leave out.
He talked to me in the bathroom. He said, "Am I going to be okay?" I said, "Yeah, it's too bad you don't know how to spell sensei."
I'm going to try the most simple move in all styles. right here. I'm going to try to do a knockout with just that move. It's like the seventh move in pinyon two. You know, you go like that and you come over here like this. And what he's going to be doing, I'll rehearse it first. He's punching. I'm going to use my parry to hit a point here. Now I'm getting ready to do the down block. I'm going to come, hit gallbladder 31, gallbladder 20. I'm going to leave out what I usually do, stomp down on 41 and 42 after I hit this. I'm going to leave that one out. Okay, go ahead. Too soft. Hold on.
Yeah.
I'm trying to baby him too much.
Okay, need that gallbladder. Move, okay, go you move. Need to need that gallbladder because it's in deep.
Okay, go ahead.
There you go. There you go. Wow.
Here, like that, out of that kata, and he's going to be grabbing me, and I'm in this position right now with the augmented. I'm going to try to just tap here on the intestine, slap the other intestine. I'm going to come into stomach five real lightly, not enough to knock him out, and come back like that. I've never tried this on any of my students, so I hope it works here. Take it in. Nope.
Yes, yes, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
I'm open to hit it, use my technique. But I can also use my trap, wrist, and get him down, and punch.
Oh, good.
Leg lock underneath.
Leg lock. Well, hope you got a picture of that kid.
Think so. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow.
Okay, who's next?
Brotherly love.
It does say climb, doesn't it?
Who's fighting who?
Turn for the camera.
This is how to kind of go to Shiho. Hands come out in this manner. Comes out in a cat stance. And I tell him I'm going to kick him on the inside of the leg. My hands go in this manner. I'm going to touch stomach five just lightly. I slap down here and I touch him on the inside of the leg. Just this move.
Ooh, wow. Oh, good. Get him, get him, get him, get him.
And grab in here, super scapular nerve, right on the collarbone, and strike straight into here as I catch tripling in points down here. Yeah. So he reaches up to grab first and start the attack.
Restore their energy right away. It's no good to leave them out too long. Sorry.
His ears come back.
So either part.
Now he still gets there. All right, good job. Thank you.
A little touch.
Fight's over.
Fight's over. So it doesn't take much.
Good.
Move
I'm going to try. I think we're going to try this, but I'm going to try and knock him out without touching him.
Wow.
Excellent. Adam Nahanchi. Nahanchi tells us to. Gives us a roadmap down here and here and here. Tells me from a bear hug, if you're gonna grab me, I can get spleen here, okay, and I can get some points right here. So I'm gonna get spleen here, loosen him up here, and that gives me about right there. Stomach five.
Wow. Knockout. When you see a guy go like that, the fight's still over. I mean, you can hit him again if you want, but when they do it with just touches and taps, that's very impressive.
This move's out of Pinan 4, the opening move, here, walking through. It's a grab and a punch. All I'm doing is I'm coming in and I'm striking both lung points, and at the same time, I'm closing in on them, striking gallbladder 20, gallbladder in the body. Put them out.
That's what the opponent tells you. That's all.
Very simple moves and make a knockout out of them. The last seminar I did a 1,000 block. This time I'm going to do 10 okada, just where you go like this and come down here. I'm going to try to do a fire to a metal. I'm going to do a mini fire to a metal with these two intestine points. And then I'm going to make the fire a little bit stronger by coming to this wood point right afterwards. So pericardium, right to the top of the triple crossing. Then I'm going to short these two out and make a little circle.
Wow.
Theory of hitting a point consecutively until, like, the first time it takes the meridian weaker, second time weaker, and third time it goes out. So he's going to punch. I'm going to come here. I'm going to build. I'm going to hit 20 once. Come over these points right here and hit 20 a second time. And I should be able to take them out with a real light touch because I'm setting them up. Here.
Oh, good.
And the kata, basically the beginning, we always announce them, and we always do down blocks and slaps off the beginning. Like, nobody ever really says what the announcement of a kata is. And I asked Sensei Coleman, you know, and he said, think about it and use it. And I can come here off of points, slap him here. I come off the eye, or off the ear like we did today. Take my gallbladder off the back, bring him around, go to cat stance, hit the eye points.
Wow, that was excellent.
And take him right out. And this is the simplest part of any kata that we have, because it's our basic announcement.
Well, Pino kata, because Remy does his forms, and he's got that moves that does like this kind of stuff, and I was going, geez, I gotta relate that to pressure points. So, I started thinking about one of his throws he does, where the move looks real similar to that. This guy's gonna punch. Hi, wait. Here. And Remy does a throw where he'll come here, and he'll throw the guy down this way, or else he'll pull him in. And so what I'll do, just relate to pressure points, is I'll come here for my parry, and then I'll actually pop gallbladder. And I'll pull the guy in here. And then from this direction, can you hear, please?
Sorry.
There we go.
Good.
Wow. He hit the three gallbladder on the head if you want to watch it.
this kata tempi that we were talking about earlier. And the part of the kata, the movement of the kata, is just simply that. So it comes from here, goes up, and then it finishes. But we'll just do that part. And what we're going to do is just going to tap the inside of the leg, liver 7, and then we'll touch gallbladder, and then we'll close on 5. Then we'll have it from just a grab, and I'll just use this to encourage the movement whenever I touch the leg, so I can get the gallbladder. So, he's all gripped up, everything's stretched out, just get in here, pop, pop.
Wow.
This is a movement of a kusanku, comes up like this, and then chops to either side. Now, as Master Dillman said earlier, you wouldn't do that if they had a hold of you, wouldn't come up this way. But if their energy is coming towards you, then you could take the arms and redirect their flow of energy. So if he's coming up, I'm going to come up here, catching one, hitting fire here, grabbing the wrist here, and then coming up to gallbladder 20 there, tapping them. Oh.
Another guy puts his hand on your leg.
As a psychologist, would you mind? I worked at a detox center, this happened. I wish I'd have known that then. I wouldn't have got it. But a guy reaches, like you're sitting there, and they come up out of their chair, and they're going to grab you this way. You'll probably come over here, I think. Okay? I'm just going to lock down here to fire up the points. And what we do, like you said today, I'd probably kick here, but with clients I had, you'd probably kick here because of the spleen thing in case they were on drugs.
Right.
So you have them fired here. I'll just do it light. So this is fired up, and you may want to do a little bit more on the, like we were doing today. You're going to hit the spleen and then hit gallbladder 20. So it'll be.
You missed gallbladder 20.
Oh, yeah. Up and in. So.
That's better. It could have been a little harder, but that was nice and light.
That's, that we have in most of the forms, this one. You can use it if somebody is grabbing you. If somebody is grabbing you on your lapels, on your notebook, as you're coming up, you'd actually be hitting triple warmer. I don't want to activate that much on this guy since Master Dillman's already worked on him a bit. So put your arms down just a bit, lock your jaw. What you're actually coming to is the stomach point on the jawline and directly under the chin. Lock your teeth together.
Whoa.
Ni Sen Chi here. If he's reaching or whatever, we're going to grab the finger, go back to the cat stance. Catch large intestine here to gallbladder, and just tap him, and then just tap stomach.
Yep.
What I'm going to do is have a kind of chento where it comes back like this, and then here, he grabs.
Yeah.
He grabs, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back into a cat stance, activating triple warmer 3 on the back of his hand, going to large intestine 4, and then finishing off with the stretch of gallbladder 13, 14, and 15. When he grabs, come back. 1, 2.
Nice job.
Looking through the TV channels one time, I was Stooges were on.
No,
Chuck Norris, religious evangelist, and with their little, you know, bless this child. And I figured, well, I could probably come up with something a little better than that. What we're going to do is I'm going to take it right out of this from like a reach or a grab, and I'm going to light him up on the wrist points. As he comes to the wrist points, and this one's kind of fun, we're going to take it right like this. And it's a bit of overkill, but I think it's pretty fun. So, I had to get you. Come at you, man.
Stomach, liver, and gallbladder on this side. He's going to grab me, and it's going to be quiet. This is just going to come in and go. At the end of P-9-1, we've worked on one breakdown up until today. We do this. So it's going to start with a grappling and then with a strike. So it's from a push. We'll come down on the arm here, wrap up, up and on the inside. You can tread on the foot this way, and then put the gallbladder back here. So we'll start. This way. Wrap up. Take down. So, let's strike and gallbladder 20.
So the move will look like the start of the kata, and then just and put them down. And basically, if the person has grabbed you, points that we worked up here on the upper arm today, I'm going to roll in, I'm going to touch four, I'm going to touch large intestine, which will bring him down. I'm on this point here, and I just come up.
Good.
Katas that come like this here, where the arm will come down, and that's going to catch like this. What I'm going to do is if he grabs me here, I'm going to hit a point right into here to get that motion right here like this, keep your jaw together.
Beautiful.
I'll use off the same type of a motion here. Guys go there. Okay. I could either push this point, hit this point here. I'm going to tap him straight in on stomach here like this, and then I'm going to redirect the energy.
Ready? Wow. Pretty good. See how fast you went to sleep.
This is going to be a move out of pin 5.
Play to the camera.
All right. Always moving pin 5. We go from here. We always turn all the way around. You go down on one knee, double strike.
Okay.
Now I'm going to do this from a move. Master Dillman talks about stepping to the side while parrying and catching the punch. I'm going to do this from a move where he punches. We do this here. Now as we're doing this, we can light up points on the outside of the arm. Okay. Today's purpose, I'm not going to do so, all right? Next move in the kata is the spin with that there, okay? I'm going to show this as taking this leg, using a bend, being nice to him. You could attack points in the back of the leg, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to grab large intestine 18 and give gallbladder a pop.
Wow. And actually, he'd go better if you knee gallbladder on the leg.
Well, you know that. Yes, when I've done it before,
yep.
They seem to go real easy with this. So.
Okay.
It's going to punch. You. Here. Then. Go slow. Nice pop.
Beautiful.
Here to catch.
Will you be?
Yeah, you got to catch.
We don't want anybody to hit the floor and hurt themselves. Well, we put catches.
The name of Master Dillman's first book is Kishu Jitsu, which means 1 second fighting. What I'm going to do here is from our first kata, Taoka 1,
It starts off, you know the man's in front of you, and it turns here, down block, punch, down block, punch. It does it on both sides. To me, that says, okay, I can go this side with it, or I can go that side with it, whichever way he presents himself. Now, the Kyushu-Jitsu, the 1 second, I'm not necessarily going to knock him out, but the fight is going to be in my court within 1 second. So if he grabs me, all right, I see this leg is forward now. So I'm going to take my kata, and I'm going to go to this side first. I'm going to use the C-step as we talked, and my down block, down strike. Instead of kicking down in the point that Master Dillman talked about dislocating for the I'm going to come up on spleen six, come back around, and just hook the leg, stretch in the meridian, and then pop it in on spleen. And then my final follow through would be for that, and that would definitely make him go. So the lock in here, large intestine.
Oh, he's out already. He's out already.
This is Will Higginbotham and Dave Wilson and I, we were at the small circle camp. We all came out to do knockouts. Leon J asked us to do knockouts, and all three of us did a knockout from the opening move of Nahanchi. We all did this, but it was all different techniques. So I thought that was really, really good, because it's showing everybody's thinking, and there's just a ton of different ways, whatever you think. I mean, we can show you something, but whatever you think up yourself and you remember, that's the way you're going to practice. I'm going to take this same thing, somebody grabbing a hold of me, where, you know, he's grabbing, getting ready to pull me in. I'm going to take the move down like this, stepping over, and that's all I'm going to do. The follow through would be grabbing the arm and striking out, hitting the gallbladder 20. I'm going to lock in on the wrist points. This is going to be my arm coming to my waist. I'm going to take my hand into conception four, and I'm going to kick spleen six. Spleen six is where the three leg ends meet down on the leg, and both legs come up and they meet at conception four. And locking into the arm, I have a overabundance of cycle destruction and a yin and yang going on. I'm going to lock in on the wrist. Hey!
Oh, geez. Wow.
Ooh, I like that.
Well, I like that.
Go off the same concept of beginning in the Hanchi Kata. I've done this before. I want to use triple yin, but I'm just going to squeeze and pinch it. Around a confrontation, and a guy decides to kick me. They don't have to know karate to want to try to kick a guy in the groin in a realistic situation. It doesn't have to be a karate technique. They just move. Pull off and kick you in the groin. So with the first movement in the kata, we step like this, go here and here. I'm going to take half of this and half of this movement and strike this way. I'll be going to conception vessel 14 and gallbladder 20. When he throws the kick, I am to start my step. As I come across with this, go ahead and kick right between the legs. We're going to lock in. If I catch a little sooner, here I lock in with the bone right on triple yin. I tap and tap. This works good for me for the long arms, so people with long arms can think about this technique being a good technique for them. So if he throws the technique, lock.
Good. Very, very light touches.
And gallbladder 20.
Hard. Very good.
Okay, this is how it kind of goes, Chiho. I like this one. It's just this movement here, just footsteps forward and cat stance. And to me, that's reminding me just to kick him on the inside of the leg. On the triple yin crossing up in here. These hands coming down. But it was tack the jaw. Okay, one hand goes down, one hand goes up. And really, I'm really just tapping it, okay? Let's keep it good.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Get his head suit in my way. All of this is crystal. It attaches here. Right in the new magazine is somebody doing this to the nose. You weren't injured. I look, that don't injure. This injures because the nerve for the attachment is here. And if I attack like that, look what would happen. The attack is down and in. The nerve's response is here. And look at the size of his pupil.
Oh, yeah.
Sit down. That is the angle and direction to attack the nose, not up. You understand that, ladies? Now, if a guy is diving at you, and I don't care from what position, this is the correct angle and direction for the nose. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
That's the angle and direction. And this, in case it didn't work, is to grab the two opposite sides of his head and break his neck. So if the guy dives, at the same time you are to touch nose, come over here a little bit, at the same time you are to touch nose, on the yin from the front, you're going to hit the yang from the back. And this would be the move, as in the kata. And if he reaches out to get me, and I touch, get his head straight. And look at the eyes. Look, we can't get him open. Okay, okay. Sorry. You just relax a minute. Just stay right there. Everybody understand?
Yes.
Then, if you missed, you have this for the yank. You're gonna rip that head around that way and yank. And really snap the neck or whiplash. So the last time I was here in October, I showed what to do with a stranglehold. Remember that?
Yes, sir.
Showed you how to release the throat. We release the throat, but if a guy's diving for you, this is a natural reaction. And it's in the kata. If every time you did that in kata, you thought a guy was diving. They had sumo wrestlers, they had people diving for people when the katas were invented. And a lot of the moves cover that, or even just coming around with the hands. If I circle ahead and tap,
get his back straight.
Look at those pupils. You see? The pupils are large. That's this move out of Seisan. Kata Seisan ends with this. That's the move. Just tap the opposite quadrants. And it puts you out, doesn't it?
Yes.
Hello?
I'm trying to get lighter and lighter on. And I've had some problems with it, but on some body styles of people, I can get it real good. And he happens to be one of them.
Yeah.
So what I do is I'm just going to activate 3 points, disrupt the energy in that meridian.
He's out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
I got it.
I just wanted to show you.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he's out.
I believe that.
Before you pass the test.
I believe that.
From the
camera.
From the hunchy, using the same opening movements he used, just a different interpretation of it. What this one is he pushes with this hand. What I'm going to do, it's a move Wally J does actually, you come up and catch here, and then I'm going to push on triple warmer to get him like this. Now earlier in the day, you know, so he was coming over to here, right? So I get him there, then I just release with my hand, and boom.
Yeah, that's real effective. Wow, yes. Yeah, that's great.
Okay, let's say he's grabbed me. But then, since he's a big bully anyway, he decides to kick me. So I trap, I cross, this brings him here, then my hand, usually when I move their leg over, excuse me,